Soto is number one, Hernandez is number two, Ozuna is number three, Arroyo is four, Lopez is 13, Gomez is 30, Chavez is 32.
Yep, that's what I got here, one, two.
Wait, can you guys hear us?
Can you hear us? Check.
Hello?
Check tiger. Testing.
Alright, okay. Alright, yeah. Yeah, yeah, your mic. Alright, okay. Testing, good? Alright. Are the cameras recording already? Okay. Alright, after this drive. Yeah. Alright, after this shot we'll start because they keep hitting. Yeah. After this shot we'll start.
Two.
That's a foul.
Yeah, I know what the field goal is. Yeah, when they think it at the bank, yeah.
Okay, good.
Those are like basic terminology there.
For example, so the two-pointers is two goals, so it's not long, two.
Right.
It's not a thing to score.
Okay. Second shot by Bustillo, recovered by the Mustangs. Orduno. Lopez. Got a couple tires in front of him. Orduno. Ball fumbled by Hernandez and it's going to be Tiger ball. Take out.
Tough turnover after a great start to the offense. You know, they got to be better at that and this game could be theirs.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you're just joining us right now, it's 1 minute with 29 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Mustangs up by 2, 6-4. Steal. Takes it into Mustang territory. Kind of.
Like he was
pushed back.
Foul
called against the Mustangs.
Great defense so far. You know, obviously the foul came in, which they should have done. Just the great defense of the team on Bobby with the steal. Incredible.
Tremendous defense right now, especially in the paint. Again, Tigers fighting for the ball, rebounding in place, and...
Hey! 25!
Foul call again. Two shots up, coming up for the Mustangs. First one in. Orduno, the shooter on the free throw. Another one made. Last one coming up. Take it up the paint. He's gonna get a free throw after that.
What a great finish from number 15. And honestly, by the way, I think it's a great finish. need to come here. Little rebound by Arleta.
Ogino to Soto. Tries to lay it up, it's blocked, denied by the Tigers. Gomez for the shot, no good. Rebounded by the Tigers. Gomez will not let it slide. Mustangs recover the rebound and they lay it up for 2 points.
One thing I'm curious, Stephen will have to hold the ball and his possessions. That's the one thing that is becoming a huge problem for them so far. Let's see how they do on offense.
Arleta with the resiliency, they just refuse to let play slide. They want those points, and badly. Rodriguez tries to pass it, swatted down. Ogino tries to lay it up. No good. Rebounded by Rodriguez. And that will be the end of the first quarter of this ball game.
Obviously, we see frustration here on the bench, but that's not the thing that matters. The one thing that I see is this team just has to rebound the ball more and be a lot more aggressive when it comes to playing defense. Because as you see, they, like I said before, they weren't exactly rebounding, and they just need to be more better when it comes to that, and a lot more better.
And you talked about problems, that's right. They had more than 25 rebounds, both of these teams combined as a whole. There's been a lot of missed shots by both teams, and this the combination of these two scores would be much bigger. Yeah, the shots, of course.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And that's just a problem that they have to see. And, yeah. Thank you guys for joining us here late. That's a technical difficulty. We'll get back. Technical difficulty. Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah.
Coming up. We got the Mustangs leading the Tigers by 10, 14-4 game. Alright, I'm actually put this away. I'll put this away. Bustillo. Tries to pass it to Rodriguez. Little miscommunication on the play. Mustang ball. Gomez to take it out.
If Arleta just keeps up with this defense and how the way they're playing, forcing turnovers, this can get a big win for them.
Oh, and you're right. Herrera. Gomez. Back to this shot on the play, rebounded by Bustillo, and the Tigers now have possession. Drives it up to the paint, and he's fouled. Two shots for the Tigers.
And you see that, just great fast play by Bobby Bustillo. That gives him the momentum to be able to shoot these free throws and draw the foul. Draw the foul, and now they're able to shoot free throws.
First shot, no good. Bustillo's got two shots. A little more than 7 minutes remaining in the second quarter. Attempts a second shot and it goes in. Tigers reduce their deficit to only 9. Ogino to Gomez, takes the 3-point shot. No good. Rebounded by the Tigers. And it's given back to Bustillo. Villegas on the rebound. Quick block by Gomez. And an amazing pass. He lays it up. Tries to lay it up. No good.
Gotta finish his own legs. That's just typical basketball for me.
Ooh, that was close. I was almost at the backcourt violation. Rodriguez to Munoz. Takes it to the paint. Gomez passes it to Duno and he lays it up for the Mustangs. Add on to the lead. Now leading by 11. Bustillo. What do you do? Ball goes out of bounds. It's going to be Tigers ball.
We got a substitution in. Brian Chavez, the senior. 5'9", coming in from number 30, Robert Gomez, who's also a center.
Intended to get intercepted by the Mustangs. Pass goes to Hernandez. Hernandez tries to find a receiver. Oh my god. Shot, no good. Arduino tries to lay it up. Block. Got traffic while shooting it. Arduino to Gomez to Chavez correction, and he misses the three-pointer. Tigers on the rebound.
Just a great rebound, but the one problem that Sacramento has is that they aren't getting a rebound. That's the biggest problem so far in this half.
Arduino on the layup and foul called against Bastille. What?
Number 21. Two free throws for this. Like I said before, and I'll say it again, they just got to rebound the ball, and not even just rebound, but hold on to the ball in general. So far, we got a substitution. Sebastian Rodriguez is being taken out for another Sebastian Padilla, the sophomore. First year on Varsity, so far it's been good.
Second shot goes in. Arleta to add on to the lead, now leading by 13, 18-5. A little more than 5 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in the first half. And Bastille with the ball to Mancias. Shoots for the three-pointer, no good.
Great shot, but it could have been a lot more than wide open.
Arleta, strong execution. Just didn't execute that layup. Mancias steals it.
Great steal by Mancias. And just being able to read the offense and get the ball.
And you're right. Arleta now steals it again. Herrera passes it to Soto, lays it up, and a foul call.
That's the Tigers.
Gotta work on the ball.
Shots coming up for the Mustangs.
Like I said, they gotta read the defense. Look on how the way the defense is running and how you can get to pass the ball.
First shot goes in. Sorry, I interrupted you.
Number 25, Victor Marino has been sufficiently.
And Daniel, we talked about how both of these teams have implemented a lot of defensive tactics throughout the season, right? Correction, the offseason, they've actually played a lot of defensive basketball. And right now it's actually pairing out because the Mustangs are actually very good on rebounds and also with steals.
Fantastic block.
Shot by Soto, no good. Ball's going to roll out of bounds. He saves it. And Tigers ball from the side of the court.
Great defense so far from San Fernando. Let's hope they keep it up.
Enthusiasm? Hernandez lays it up and good. Adds on another 2 points to the lead.
Dropped
up to the end line.
That's one thing they might have to look at.
Bounces it to the outside.
But other than that,
trying to find a man to the paint. Takes a shot at it instead. No good. Gomez on the rebound for the Mustangs. Dribbling it up the court. Takes it up to the paint. Lays it up. No good. Gets into the hands of the Mustang. Gomez lays it up and he goes in, but it won't count as it was a foul called right before.
I've said it before and I'll say it again, Sacramento has to play a lot more better defense and they could win this game. They just got to be able to play more defense, get better on offense, stop forcing around with the turnovers, and that's how you play good basketball. Other than that,
Isaac stepping in for number 25, Victor Marin, the true freshman, standing at 5'7". Soto tipped out a bounce by Bastille. Great defense on the play.
Great defense by Bastille. Could have gotten Bastille there, but it's just a bit too far reach.
Soto is the pass. Gomez to Lima. No good. Rolls out of bounds. And he's going to be throwing for the Tigers from their own end goal line.
Three rebound win by the Tigers. Just got to keep it up. Keep it up so far.
Cabrera takes it up to the paint. Padilla to the corner. Takes a shot at the three. No good. Rebounded by Soto. The Mustangs in full traffic to Tiger territory. Dumps it up to Herrera. No good. Rebounded by Soto. Lopez to Gomez. And he makes the two-pointer, adds on to the lead.
What a beautiful pass by Soto right over to Victor Muddy. And to me, like, that was an incredible pass. Great read by the offense. Defense, great defense, but better offense.
Arleta up by 19 with a little more than 2 minutes and 40 seconds remaining in the first half. 24-5. Lopez with the layup. No good. Ball is out of bounds.
Inbound, taken out by the Tigers.
Cabrera taking it up to the court. Tries to find a man trapped by the Mustangs. Padilla, the steal to the goal line. 3-point range, no good. Behind the backboard, it's red. You don't see that often, do you?
Not really. Maybe you can see it in college or in the NBA, but high school basketball?
Not even that, to be honest with you.
We'll see how it is. But so far, they just got to keep up with the shooting. You know, their shooting isn't the greatest, but if maybe they keep taking up shots, being more confident, then they'll get up on the board.
Shot attempted by Arroyo, no good. Rebounded by Munoz, and now Cabrera with the ball. Takes it into Mustang territory. Arleta playing strong defense, and they show it again as they collect Arroyo with the awareness onto his own side. Munoz.
That's my father with the steal.
Cabrera, the steal, up the court. Wow, that was amazing awareness by the steal, right? I mean,
incredible. Not even just amazing awareness, but great hustle back on defense. Can you give up on the play and let you back on offense?
The resilience that Bustillo has shown already for the Tigers.
To me, he's just fired up to play basketball here at Sacramento.
You're right. Rebounds. Becoming a big issue for the Tigers right now. Soto tries to lay it up again. Mancillas with the rebound. They lose the ball once again. Soto for the Mustangs. Fernandez to Gomez, tries to lay it up, blocked by Mancillas, and a foul against the Tigers.
Just like that, this wouldn't have happened if they would have gotten rebounds. Honestly, that's the one, like I said before, and I'll say it again, they just got to keep working on getting rebounds, and that's probably the biggest problem. And another problem that I see is just them holding up to the ball. That's something to them that is very valuable in basketball. And if they don't achieve that goal of getting rebounds or just holding on to the ball, then this could be a lose game for them. Subbing out is Marcos Matias. We're subbing in for him, the senior Sebastian Rodriguez.
Good. Second shot made by the Mustangs, good. Munoz, Cabrera takes the ball out, passes it to Munoz. Down the sideline, tries to take it out the paint, no good. Soto steals it, takes it up to the paint, fast break, no good. Blocked by the steal. Foul called.
Just phenomenal defense right by the steal. Great blocking, and honestly, I see great athleticism from Fernando with the steal as he can play. Let's see if he can keep it up, and hopefully bring this team back up.
You're right, the awareness is there as well as the defense. 26-5 with less than 40 seconds remaining in the second quarter. Gomez with the ball. Tigers around him. He's got Hernandez to shoot the three, no good. Soto tries to rebound it. Arroyo. Ball rolls out of bounds. Mustang ball. And We've talked about it many times before leading up to this game, that this game is going to be a good one. Right now, it's kind of a blowout. Hopefully, San Fernando picks it up for the second half.
Yeah, indeed. These teams, a very historic rivalry is what I can say. These two teams have gone at it back-to-back college in 2019 and 2020 in the city second championship games. Both have won each under their belt, and this history will continue as we play this game right now. And the rivalry, I feel like, is probably one of the best rivalries in the northeast side of the valley. And right now, it's a blowout, but hopefully San Fernando or catch up and make this into a ball game.
Absolutely, you're right. And when you actually talk about the rivalry, fun fact, in the last 9 years, they've played 14 times. The series is tied 7-7. In the last 14 matchups, 5 of those games were LA City Section playoff matches. Out of those 5 playoff matches, 2 of them are LA City Section championships. And like you said earlier, both programs have a championship under their belt in the last 4 years.
And it's not only that, but those games were incredibly close, all coming down to the wire, all coming down to calls or just great plays by how these historic teams are. So let's see how this game continues.
Pass to Gomez. Shot clock violation. It's going to be Tiger Ball. Ball will just be able to take it out.
What you should do always is just watch the clock. They should be calling down 10, 9,
10, 10, 10, 10, 10. Takes a shot out for the buzzer beater. Almost goes in, but no good. Halftime here at the San DeJohn Gymnasium.
What a great half for the Arleta Mustangs. And to them, I see that as a great victory.
By you, but if you notice, they missed a lot of rebounds, both teams. They got in a lot of rebounds. There's a lot of missed shots in this game. The problem with San Fernando is that they keep losing rebounds. It's always going to the Mustangs, right? So that's a good analysis. And we'll be right back for the second half. We'll do that next time. Mitchell Brady did it. Oh, just cut off the mics. Yeah, I know. Just cut off the mics. I know, I'm not trying to cuss, but yeah. No, just say cut off the mics.
Alright. manager, you know?
Wait,
what?
Is that video?
The audio.
Oh, okay.
Your audio's not on.
It's
Oh, wait, no, it's mute. That's why. Gosh, there was a mute. Who's the mute?
Wait, not yet.
Oh, wait, no, it is on. It is on. Yeah, shit.
Once again, and here goes the rebounds. Like we said before, San Fernando struggling with those this whole game. And Braulio Bustillo taking it. Good mid-range pass, but it's right behind the hands of Munoz. Mustang ball.
I know you can see the frustration on Braulio Bustillo has. That was not exactly on his team, it was on him himself. Not calling him out, but just better passing, and that will probably get him back into this game.
Like you said before, that's a great analysis. Arleta inside Tiger territory. Foul against the Tigers. So Daniel, you used to play basketball.
Yes, indeed.
Does this bring any nostalgia to you at all?
Of course it does. You know, just playing the game of basketball is what brings back nostalgia. Back to when I first picked up basketball when I was about 5 to 7 years old. And, you know, obviously I'm still here. I love the game. And as you see right now, I enjoy it so much to the point where I don't have this passion of being able to commentate about basketball. Not just basketball, but any other sport, whether it be football or baseball or even just any other international sport or American sport in general.
Munoz on the pass. Bustillo and referees say that he stepped out of bounds. Mustang ball.
To me, that was a great call by the ref. From my point of view, ball was stepped out of bounds. And a great read from the referee. But like I said before,
San Fernando has to really work on these turnovers, which has so far been causing them the game.
Soto with the shot. He makes it in. Adds on to their lead. 37-10. Mustangs lead it.
Great play by the Arleta offense. Just taking advantage of how sloppy the Tiger defense is and just pulling off that three. Amazing play by them.
Shot blocked by Gomez. Fast break inside the Tigers paint. Gomez, Hernandez takes a shot at it from the corner, and it's good.
And just like I said earlier, taking advantage of this San Fernando defense and just being able to come in and just being able to shoot however they want, as how I see them. And just hopefully how this San Fernando offense can play way better. And fantastic three-point by the end of the game. Got my hopes right out there when it comes to how San Fernando is playing right now.
San Fernando cutting their deficit to only 27 points now. Three from the corner.
What a momentum from Arleta. Taking advantage of, like I said, I'll say it again, of how this defense is playing. And Arleta, he's hitting those shots, and this game could be back.
You're right, Arduino ran out. Man, what a monster. He's just been making nine free throws. He's already made three free throws. He's already made 2 3-pointers. And he's already made like five layups, I think.
So far, Arleta is dominating this game.
Absolutely.
Arleta has been struggling. Obviously, a home opener, they could be a little bit nervous, maybe a little bit, nerve-wracking to them. So, but to them, you know, they got to be able to play a lot better when it comes to offense and defense, just as a whole in general, and maybe even as a team, by passing the ball. Like I said before, playing defense, and most importantly, rebounding the ball.
Timeout called by the Tigers.
I believe it's the first timeout, but we're about to get into the game. They have 2 full timeouts remaining and about 2 30-second timeouts left, according to my script.
1 minute and 18 seconds remaining here in the third quarter. Mustangs 43, Tigers 13. And so far it's been an Arleta defensive show in the last 2.5 quarters, and looks like we might even see more. Mencias blocked. Arleta steals it. Gomez finds Hernandez, 3-pointer. He makes it inside. Correction, that's Arduino, the same guy that has made already 3 3-pointers in a row.
This fantastic offense by Arleta, you know, they keep hitting these 3-pointers, and that's cutting, making their lead a lot larger and just making this San Fernando team embarrassed right now.
It's been a defensive show, and it's actually came down to who could play the better defense right now. Arleta has been showing it. Foul called.
No shot on the floor. Arleta ball.
Jose Villalobos subbing in for number 34, Sebastian Rodriguez. Less than 20 seconds remaining in the third quarter.
Sebastian Padilla coming in for Marcos Macias.
33-point gain.
An absolute defensive and offensive dominant play from Arleta. And another safety.
And of course, Daniel, you played basketball before. What is it that San Fernando could do right now to kind of build up momentum to a lead, potentially?
Just back to the simple stuff, you know, not with the turnover. Just try to, like, build. Obviously, you can't build a bond within a day, but if you can sort of try to build that chemistry in and have faith and confidence, that could lead to a win, or that could lead to a lot of momentum and maybe even a win.
gotta stop acting like this. You returners, you gotta stop acting like this. Three right here. Come on, man. Just got beat that shit out of the door. The excuse is that.
Thing that is happening right now with San Fernando so far and how they're not playing their greatest.
With that question, there's a lot of answers, right? But I've actually talked to Bustillo actually earlier today, and he told me it's all about experience. These young guys got to get experience. But also him, he's got to take accountability with leading these younger guys into varsity and potentially going to be future.
That out here in discussion when it came back to it. That's one thing that these guys have to play. Marcos Mencias, Braulio Bustillo, even Sebastian Rodriguez, who's only been here for about 2 years. But to them, they got to be able to have and take a transition to these young sophomores and even a freshman in this basketball varsity team.
Marin Bustillo for the three, no good. Rebounded by the Mustangs. Orduno taking it into Tiger territory. The Mustangs playing a little passing drills. Hernandez lays it up and one.
Man, man, what a beautiful pass by Bahal. Just the great athleticism from this other team. I'll get a free throw. Abraham Soto.
Cabrera loses the ball. Another problem that the Tigers have faced in the game. Soto. Mustang inside the paint. Orduno.
In the paint, that is a turnover. That's a problem.
San Fernando ball, like Daniel just pointed out right now. And Cabrera. Marin, Victor Marin, takes it to the paint. Finds Cabrera wide open for the three, no good. Rebounded by Gomez and for the Mustangs. Pass to Hernandez, but mishandles it. Tiger ball from their own end line.
Got to take advantage of those turnovers right there. San Fernando had a huge turnover right here with the air ball, but then Arleta came right back, but then has to keep the ball together. So one thing that they have to do.
And you're right. The rebound, or correction, the layup was right in front of him. No excuses for that.
Exactly.
Gomez. Chavez. From the three-point, takes it up to the paint, loses the ball. Hernandez. Shot no good. Cabrera. Fast break for the Tigers. Draws a foul and one.
What a great finish by Cabrera. Him being able to hustle down the court, being able to get around two defenders around him and drawing the foul and score. Incredible play from there.
Yes, Cabrera is just a freshman.
No.
Freshman. He's a freshman. He's got a lot of time to develop under his belt. He's shown a lot of toughness already in this game. A lot of bravery.
He's also the ones with the fast breaks.
And of course, with a few players out right now, you know, he's taking advantage of that and playing amazing basketball so far.
Just next man up. He's just stepping.
Exactly. Great way to point it out, Gio.
Gomez takes it up to the paint. No good. Rebounded by the Tigers. Bustillo with the ball. Fast break. Takes it up the paint. Blocked by Hernandez. Bustillo with the ball. Three-point shot. No good. Gomez recovers. Rebounds for the Mustangs. Cabrera takes it up the paint. He's got Villalobos, Marin, Padilla, three-point shot. Ooh, wet like water.
And that's the one thing that you've been having to work on this whole game, and you're finally executing it. Passing the ball, getting the man open, and getting it for a three.
And you're right, they've been playing a lot of hot potato in this game, but it's worked out so far. Just open three, there's open three-point shots. What else can you ask for?
Exactly, just making the shots is probably what I could ask for. But anything other than that, great so far for San Fernando when it comes to shooting.
Foul call against Marin. Correction against Cabrera. Tiger ball from the Arleta end line. Padilla, Cabrera inside the paint. Little passing game going on for the Tigers. Bustillo. Cabrera showing his handles, takes it up the court, and
there's my baseline foul. Goes for Cabrera. It's good.
All right. It was two shots. Two shots coming up for Cabrera. He already made one. He made one. Mustangs 54, Tigers 20. Makes the second shot. Make that 54 to 21.
So far, this lead is getting coming down. Hopefully. This confidence leads them back into a much less margin in this game.
Rebounded by Padilla. Bustillo, fast drive. Tries to make the shot, no good, but draws a foul.
Great aggressiveness from Barrio Bustillo. Him being able to get that rebound and take off immediately with his man right behind him. And just great way to draw a foul.
You're right, first shot out of two, good. Reduces their deficit, now they have 22 points on the board. Second shot, good, now they have 23 on the board. Lopez with the layup, no good. Cabrera, fast break for the Tigers. Loses handles on it. And it's going to be Tiger ball. Mustang defender touched it right before out of bounds. Bustillo passed by Cabrera. More like the assist and makes it for the three.
Just great offense coming from San Fernando. Them being able to take advantage of how our lead is. Sort of communication was not the best. And Bustillo being able to take advantage of that and make it open to three right there. And you can hear how a little player is just like yelling out in his face. Again, let that get to him and make a shot.
Lopez takes a shot, no good. Rebounded by the Tigers. Padilla inside of the paint. Tries to find Villalobos and
double dribble by Sebastian Padilla. As you can see right there, that was a costly mistake for the Tigers. Sebastian Padilla was very hesitant, as you saw. He could have drove in, but got to be more aggressive in these games, especially in the paint.
Yeah, you're right. You know, the paint has been very costly for the San Fernando Tigers. Lopez, tipped up by Cabrera. Mustangs, shot made by Hernandez, 3-point good.
Hernandez has been on fire when it comes to 3-pointers today. Absolute machine when it comes to it.
It was Arduino, correction, ladies and gentlemen.
Sorry, correction.
Bustillo takes a shot at it. Oh, and in! That's three-pointers consecutively.
Crazy. They're trading points back and forth like it's the stock market up here. Just an incredible way how these two Arleta teams are playing.
Great comparison to the stock market. The stock market isn't doing too well right now these days. But anyway.
And a foul.
Foul called.
Just great aggression by Lopez here coming into it, being aggressive, drawing the foul, and getting the free throw.
Hernandez lays, tries to lay it up. Foul called against the Tigers. Arleta leading 59-30 with a little more than 2 minutes and 50 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Orduno, three, money. He's made it look so easy tonight.
Incredible way by Orduno, and just a great way to start off this game. Incredible game for Orduno so far, especially when it comes to three-pointing, but just playmaking off the game.
Yeah. Oh, my bad. My bad.
Two free throws for Bali to steal.
First shot coming up, good. Makes it inside. Reduces their deficit, now they got 30 on the board.
Braulio. Coming off of Sebastian Padilla. A little wild, but not taking advantage of those open layups. As you can see, he's wide open. And could have used it, but also bad ball placement, and that could have been an easy layup for Arleta to even enlarge this deficit up, but sadly cannot obtain.
Good. Cabrera tries to drive it up the paint. Bastille for the three-pointer, no good. Rebounded by Lopez. A fight for it. Arleta takes over. Orduno for the three. No good. Fight for the ball. Lopez with the shot. 2 points, no good. Ball swinged out to Bastille. Fast break on the play. Bastille lays it up. No good.
Arleta slowing down the ball here as we have about a minute left into this game. So far from how it looks, Arleta is playing phenomenal. And, especially three-pointing wise, Abraham Soto, incredible junior out on Arleta, just created that amazing three for Arleta.
Bastille with the three-point shot, trying to get some revenge, no good.
Great rebound by Jose.
Rodriguez, Cabrera. Now to Bastille, Villalobos tries to lay it up, no good. Fight for the ball, rebound by the Mustangs. Soto. To Orduno, 3-point shot. No good. Rebounded by Soto again. Lopez pivots, takes a shot at it. No good. Rebounds have been a big problem for the San Fernando defense.
And obviously, yeah, when it comes to defensively, offensively, Arleta has been playing amazing when it comes to offensive rebounds. And that's not, obviously, it's not a great thing for San Fernando, as their defensive rebounds have not been the greatest this game.
3-point shot, no good. Lopez takes a shot at it, and inside. This time it's good.
That's a sealer for this Arleta team, and just a great way to end this game. You know, bad way to start for this San Fernando team, and just the way how I saw it, like, they had that ball in their hands and just threw it away. Literally, they threw it away. And to me, Arleta took advantage of that many times in this game, and as you can see from the scoreboard, they got a victory out of it.
10 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Both shots in.
Bastille with the layup, it's good.
Correction, ladies and gentlemen, that's going to be game. Mustangs beat the Tigers 68-36.
Just the way how I see it, you know, San Fernando obviously coming off and now starting off. To me, how I see it, from the looks of it, they just got to keep rebounding. Practice rebounds, you know, keep doing those offensive drills that some people have seen in practice. And hopefully this will enlighten their season. Arleta, fantastic game when it came to shooting. Three pointers, of course, when it came to Marcus Oduno. And just incredibly, like, just how the way it became. And to me, like, that's a great way how Arleta played this game. And incredibly, just incredible way how Arleta played. San Fernando, obviously, they got to step it up, especially for the seniors that come this year. And just got to bring that frustration that they have right now and push it all the way towards the team season.
Right.
Oh,